This is continuation of RCM reverse charge mechanism. Up to 9 point we have understood from that exemption, this notification number 13/2017. Balance 5 points are here on my board. There is some committee called overseeing committee. Okay, this committee is constituted by RBI to give consultancy to RBI. Okay, so there are members, individual members who are industry expert who can give, you know, consultancy services to RBI on monetary policy, how to handle now this dollar crisis, rupee dollar crisis, how to handle GDP. So some insight they will give. They are independent agencies, because there is no one or two or three. There may be more than 10, more than 20. We don't know how many committees RBI may form. So in that case, they are saying this member of overseeing committee will not take headache of paying of tax on their consultancy services. RBI should pay tax. Who will pay tax? RBI. So again, reverse charge mechanism. RBI is more reliable person for us, so RBI is paying tax. Then you might have received so many calls, and even today also you will receive some of the call where the telecall operator will say, sir, there is a loan approved on your name, sir, there is a credit card approved on your name, sir, please buy insurance from us, sir, please buy holiday package from us. Yes or no? So many calls come. That is telecalling business or telemarketing business. So banks don't do that. Banks are not allowed to do direct telecalling marketing. So again, banks, what do they for marketing, for competitive marketing? Bank will give this contract to some agencies, you know, call centers. Yes or no? All right. So the call, that when this call comes to you, know, from person, I'm from HSBC Bank or I'm from ICICI Bank, technically they are not from bank, they are private agencies working on behalf of bank. So the technical name given to them in banking industry is DCA. Okay, DSA means direct selling agent. So they are direct selling agent of ICICI Bank. Therefore, they say, okay, we are calling from ICICI Bank, sir, you can get credit card from ICICI Bank. Okay. Now, again, these agents are small in number, scattered everywhere in India. Yes or no? Yes. All right. And collection of tax is again difficult. And they are not big corporate type of people. Okay. Small agent, like if I wanted to become DSA, then I have to have 3-4 telecallers with me and I will get agency. So government again said collection of taxes from DSAs will be very difficult. So instead of direct selling agent, you collect tax from bank. But if direct selling agent is very big type of agent, like 50 employees are there, it's a private limited company or partnership firm or LLP, then it is in forward charge only, then it is not in reverse charge. Then the DSA itself will pay tax. But you are an individual DSA, proprietorship firm, small DSA, then you are under reverse charge mechanism. So here it's not that all DSAs are under reverse charge mechanism, only small DSAs are under reverse charge mechanism, because big DSAs are removed from reverse charge. When something is removed from a reverse charge, it is in forward charge. Okay. Again, before doing demonetization happened in 2016, to be very precise, 8 November 2016, night 8 o'clock. Yes or no? That is a precise time. You should understand demonetization has taken place before demonetization, because now so many people have this cash, 500 rupees and old 1000 rupees notes, and they need to deposit in bank. Government was having all these ideas even prior to that. So government had brought 1 year in advance Jandhan Yojana. Do you understand this Jandhan Yojana? Under Jandhan Yojana, government had proposed to banks that please go to small villages and small towns and force people or request people to open bank account. So that gas subsidy will be directly credited to bank account, their benefits will be directly deposited in their bank account, some interest benefit will be given to them. Yes or no? Yes. All right. Now this rural people or this small town people, they may not come to bank to open bank account. So what government told banks, you go to village, take that your pad, the iPad or, you know, some digital pad, and then go there, take photographs on the spot, scan their Aadhaar card or PAN card, whatever document they give, take sign only also on that pad itself, and open account in his house. Don't ask him to come to bank, because he will not come. Hello. Now bank doesn't have this kind of manpower with them. Yes or no? That people will go to villages and small towns and get this accounting done. So bank will appoint agents. Those agents are business facilitators. Business facilitators, and business facilitators will work on behalf of bank. Again, they will be in so many numbers. Instead of taking tax from business facilitators, we are taking tax from banks. Am I clear? Yes. Now, similar concept is there, like business facilitators, we are having concept of business correspondence. business correspondent. So when you take loan, if you know this, somebody will come to verify whether you actually stay here or not. Yes or no?
Yes.
Whether you actually, so cross verification, if you are giving that you are working in XYZ company, they will come there and ask whether you are actually working there or not. Okay, some documentation work has to be done. All right, some charge document has to be created. So certain like daily activities of bank has to be taken care. Though the daily activities will be taken care by business correspondents of the bank. Okay, so when I say BF, BF means business facilitators. Okay, BF is in reverse charge. People also assume BC is also reverse charge. No, 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 no. BC is not in reverse charge. Business correspondent are in forward charge. Hello, there are two types of agent which help banks for banking operation. One is BF, business facilitators. Second is BC, business correspondent. There are two different types of agent. Business correspondent help bank in day-to-day operations. Okay, yes. All right. Business correspondent are in forward charge. They are not in reverse charge. Okay, there is a name in this reverse charge mechanism for business correspondent, but don't assume that they are in reverse charge. I'm trying to put it very clearly in your mind. Business facilitators, BF, are in reverse charge. So BF to bank, bank will pay tax. BC to bank, BC will pay tax. Yes. Hello. All right. Then who is here, sir? Now this BC will appoint sub agents. Hello. Main business correspondent will appoint sub agent. That sub agent is providing services to business correspondent, and business correspondent providing services to bank. Hello. Business correspondent to bank, they are in forward charge, but agent to business correspondent. Hello. Small agent to business correspondent, they are in reverse charge. Are you getting this?
Yes.
Agent to business correspondent in reverse charge. So small agent will pay tax or business correspondent will pay tax? Business correspondent will pay tax. Are you getting this? So BC is not in reverse charge. BC is in forward charge. BF is in reverse charge. Am I clear? Okay. So here you can understand so many agents we have covered now, isn't it? Insurance agent. In previous slide we have discussed insurance agent to insurance company. So insurance company will pay tax. Recovery agent to bank. So bank will pay tax. Here DSA, direct selling agent to bank. So who will pay tax? Bank. Business facilitator to bank. Who will pay tax? Bank. Okay. Business correspondence to bank. Business correspondent, because it is not in reverse charge. Agent of business correspondent to business correspondent. Business correspondent will pay tax. Lastly, security services. Now these security services and securities are different. That securities means shares, debenture. This security means, you know, in outside satellite park also we are having security guards, no, 5-6 security guards. They are not employee of this park. Hello. All right, they are employee of some security agency. All right. So that security agency have contract with this satellite park. Yes or no?
Yes.
All right. Outside bank also you must have seen some security agency, different logo is there. They are not bank employees. They are employee of some security agency. So those security services are also under reverse charge now. Latest amendment. This is not even there in your modules. Therefore, we are taking help from CA module. Okay. So it is not mentioned in CMA module. Therefore, but it may come in exam because in law it is amended now. Okay. In GST law it is amended. All right. So business facilitator to bank, bank will pay tax. Agent to business correspondent will pay tax. And security services provided to registered person, so registered person will pay tax. These three are recently added. Recently, just now, couple of months back. Okay. Not even years, couple of months back it was added. But this clause is not applicable to central government, state government, local authority and government agency or composition scheme dealer. There is a logic because there is an exemption given to these people. Okay. This is not even taxable because it is not taxable. We don't have to discuss whether it is in forward charge or reverse charge. So while reading, my problem is while reading reverse charge mechanism, you should have understanding of exemption. And while reading exemption, you should have understanding of reverse charge mechanism. So I cannot teach both at the same time. So I taught you some rough idea about reverse charge mechanism because this is smaller list. Then there are 86 plus exemptions we have to discuss. While discussing exemption, again I will ask, okay, this is exempt, this is exempt, this is exempt. So like I told you, lawyer services are under exemption. So I will teach you exemption. Out of 5 lawyer services, I will say 4 are exempt. Hello? Then I will say 1 is taxable. Because this 4 are exempt, then balance 1 is taxable. That taxable under which charge? Forward charge or reverse? That time you need to tell me, sir, it is taxable under reverse charge, because advocate we have discussed here. Okay, GTA I will teach you till almost 12 exemptions. 10 to 12 exemptions I will teach. After teaching 10 to 12 exemptions, I will ask, GTA is under forward charge or reverse charge? So you will say, sir, GTA is under reverse charge. Are you getting this? Okay, so when we are going to discuss exemptions, we should discuss reverse charge again in more detail. Okay, yeah, sure. Yeah, so this is end of reverse charge mechanism from CGST Act. From CGST Act. Now we have to discuss some exemption notification, charging section and reverse charge mechanism from IGST Act. Okay.